Hello, welcome to this course on Terminal Essentials. This video is intended to be a fast track for those who are already familiar with the terminal. To follow along, I have the files in this Git repository. You go to this URL and the files are here. You can also download the zip file and unzip it. The zip file is just a zip of all of this content. I have this already on my computer. And I'm using Git Bash for Windows. I have it on my desktop. The file content is like this. We list the content of the file. And if you want to list all the contents of the files recursively and showing the hidden files, you see here, that's how we do that. If you want to list the content of a particular directory, for example, lesson one, we do it like that. I clear the screen to make things tidy, clear. I can also list the content of lesson one and lesson two at the same time, like so. It shows the lesson one and it shows you the content of lesson one. I make it a little bit bigger. That's how you list the content of a directory. To move from one directory to another, you use the cd command. Cd, for example, move to lesson one. And with ls here, you see the content of lesson one, just in ls command. If you cd without passing any argument, you will be sent to your home directory. If you cd and you pass the minus sign, you go to the previous directory. You can also cd using the relative path notation to go two steps back. If I cd minus, go back to where I'm coming from. If I cd one step back, I go to the home directory where we started, Terminal Essentials. Clear the screen to make things tidy. In order to know the present current directory, the full path, press the pwt command. This prints the absolute path of the current working directory. The absolute path always starts with its forward slash from the root. We can also change to the desktop by copying that directory, and you cd, you paste that here and you go to the desktop. That is about file management. Oh, that is system navigation. Sorry. For file management, we can also reproduce the content of Terminal Essentials. We can create another directory here with all the contents of Terminal Essentials, like so. I will call it Terminal Essentials 101. To create a directory, make directory. You give the directory name, Terminal Essentials 101. This has created Terminal Essentials 101 in this desktop. So if I change to that, Essentials 101, we have it here. To create those two directories, I can do make directory. I create lesson one and lesson two at the same time. To create a file, use the touch command to create the file names.txt. If you touch, give the file name, and we have it here. We also create the .hide.me file .txt. Clear and list the content recursively. That's how we see it. Oh, we don't have text one and text two in lesson one and lesson two respectively. It's easy. Touch lesson one, text one.txt, lesson two, text two.txt. If I repeat the last command, arrow up button, you see that we have the same file structure as we have in Terminal Essentials. I can also list the content of Terminal Essentials. Go one step back, Terminal Essentials. And you see the contents are the same. This is the content, or this is listing the content of Terminal Essentials 101. And this lists the content of Terminal Essentials. And you see that we are the same. We just created the same file structure that we downloaded. Now to go to the next stage, like moving, copying files. Let's say we want to copy the file names.txt into lesson 2. We do cp, we give the file name and say put it into lesson 2. So now if we list the contents of lesson 2, we see that we have names.txt there. Actually, if we list the contents of this current directory, we see that we have names.txt in this current directory as well as in lesson 2. We could also copy and rename at the same time. Clear the screen. So if I list again, if I copy names.txt and I want to call it second names into inside lesson 1, I call it second names.txt. Now this copies names.txt from this parent directory to this child directory and gives it this name. That is how you copy and rename at the same time. But to rename the directory, you do as follows. For example, I want to name this directory. We do as follows. Lesson, we give MV. For example, want to name lesson 1 to module 1. That's it. Now we don't have lesson 1, we have module 1. To rename a file, it's the same. Names.txt, renamed.txt. And that's it. That's how we rename a file. I showed you how to copy files. I did not show you how to copy directories. To copy the directory called module 1 and give another name, let's say lesson 3. So we do copy module 1 lesson 3. This will complain because module 1 has some contents. So we have to do this recursively. So copy minus arrow. We are saying that we should copy everything inside lesson 1 and then put it inside lesson 3. If lesson 3 is not there, we create it. So if ls, you see that we have lesson 3 here. I can list the contents of lesson 3 and module 1. So you see that they are the same. Everything inside is the same. That's how you copy a directory and all its contents to another directory. If the directory does not exist, it is created. We just seen how we can make directory, we can make files, we can rename a directory, we can rename a file, we can copy a directory and copy a file. Let us, for example, we don't need a module 1. Let us delete it. So to delete a directory, we have a command called rmdir, and you give it a directory name, module 1. This complains rmdir only removes empty directories. Let us create an empty directory and see how that works. Mk empty directory. Now we have an empty directory. So if we do rmdir empty directory, this removes that directory. If I list again, we don't have the directory. But then how do we delete a directory and all its contents recursively? We use the rm command, minus arrow, minus f, minus arrow. We pass the minus f so that we do not have prompt. I want to pass the minus v for verbosity, and we give the directory name. So this minus arrow means recursive, minus f means not to prompt, and minus v is verbose, show us whatever is happening. You can always have these options here. If you type rm help, or all the commands that we'll be learning, you see here minus f, what it says it does, minus arrow, what it says it does, and minus v, and this is the explanation. Clear? That is how you delete a directory. You can also delete a file. You just rm and you give the file name. He asks you to confirm if you press Y, that will happen. But let us move into lesson 2. What do we have here? We have names.txt here. So to remove the file without this prompt, without a confirmation, you just rom minus f. Means that you really mean what you are doing, and then you don't have it. You should note that when you use the rom command, there is nothing like recycle bin, so the file is lost and is lost forever. That's how you remove a file, and that's how you move a directory. To see the contents of a file, let us create a file with some contents. Oh, let's see if we have the names file, but I'm not sure we have anything inside names, second names, I'm not sure. Okay, by the way, cat is a command that we use to list the contents of a file. We don't have anything here. So let's copy names.txt from the startup files and bring it here. We can do like this, copy. We know one step we are going, we are in the desktop. So we're going to terminal essentials. We copy the file names.txt here. Well, it's a, it cannot start. It means that there is a problem with the file or the directory name. It's .txt. So now we have copied names.txt from the startup files. Just to confirm that the startup file that we have it there. Terminal essentials. So we have names.txt. So we have copied the names and put it here. Clear my screen and I list this content. To view all the contents of names.txt, cat names.txt. That's it. There is another command that gives this output. You notice we have everything from 1 to 100. This file contains some names that I downloaded from the internet and ordered them alphabetically and gave them the numbers 1 to 100. To view them in a page-like manner, you use another command called less, the names.txt, and hit enter. This will list the first as much information as you can see on the screen. If I zoom, control and plus key, my keyboard, so the characters become larger, but it tries to see, show me at one line at a time. If you press the page down, it gives you page by page. And when it is end, it says the end. If you press the Q button, Q as in queen, this exits. What if you want to see the topmost? You see the top of the file. So we see head, again names.txt. It gives you the first 10 lines in that file. So what if you want to see the end line? So let's see the first 5 lines, names.txt. You see the first 5 lines there. If you want to see the last, you can imagine this is a tail, names.txt. It will spit out the last 10 lines. We can as well do some. Maybe you want to see the last 3 of names.txt. That's it. You see here, the last character or the last line here is 100. We can also append content to the file using the echo command. Let's say 101 and my name, Bernard Longer. Append this to the file called names.txt. If we repeat the last command before this, you see that now we have Bernard Longer. Let's say we name without specifying, so we see the last 10. So my name is there. That's how you append content to a file. You can also overwrite the content of this file by doing that. The same echo that we just did. But then if I put, let me see, let me just replace this with terminal essentials from programming with Benz. And I say names.txt. Now, if you say the names.txt, you have just one line. Cat names.txt, you have just one line. That is it about the fundamentals of the terminal. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you can be notified when new videos are uploaded.